Maybe it's because my blood's getting weaker. Did I re-anchor myself? Ah, damn it, did I not re-anchor myself? I did. I'm just gonna trust I did. Whatever. Let's go get Arvak's skull. Actually, this building here, I haven't checked it all out yet, have I? Oh, I must have. I'm missing some pages of Jube's Opus, I'm sure. How many are there again? I've forgotten. 12? Once I find Jube, he'll tell me. Oh, damn it. Drink the elixir of vitality when I didn't need to. Oh, hey, Serana. Sorry about leaving you back there, but, I had to take all the goodies away to our goodie chest. Oh, people holding our back skull. Oh my god, how many of these are in the Splinterdies? Let's get rid of the Mistmen first if we can. I only have to loot soul gems and bone meal. What the shit did I step into? Oh my lord. No, we're done here. We're done here. Yeah, those potions still work on me. Oh. god, this fucking mist man is getting really annoying. And he's too fast because of all the slowing. That's so annoying. I like how they can still detect me. I'm still technically being sought out by them. They're not on the map, they're not visible in any way, shape, or form, but they're still looking for me. Meaning I'm pretty sure I'm still in combat and I can't do this. No? Okay, whatever. Oh yep, no, I am still in combat. I'm still in combat. That's brilliant. Might as well just run back. I'm not gonna leave combat ever.
Welcome.
Are you serious? It wasn't just some sort of bug. I'm just stuck in combat forever. That's great. I like Requiem. I do. There's a lot of things about it that can just be dumb sometimes. It's probably more of a problem with Requiem and Skyrim than it is to do with just Requiem itself. But they're overall of this. To sneak. It's kind of annoying sometimes. They're probably unloaded now. They're probably not in a loaded cell anymore. And they're still searching for me. And that's probably part of the problem, is that they can't ever stop searching for me, and now I'm stuck in combat. I figured loading the save might realize that, oh hey, they're not loaded. They're no longer able to search for me, but nope. I'm stuck in combat forever. So many soul gems, though. So many soul gems. Why'd they let me change my ring before if I was still in combat? How are things going for Kognar? I need an update. Something to escape from all these friggin' bone men and mist men. The ghostly farmer. Everything's wrong. Here's roughly where everything went wrong. Okay, I retrieved Arvak's skull. Why is the quest not updating? Ugh. Maybe zero. Maybe one day. As long as I don't go to Requiem Soul Cairn. Fuck invisible entities. Why is this not updating? Why did it not update? What is going on? Where is Serana? Maybe the bone men wouldn't, but I can't trust those like mist men or the invisible entities. I can't trust them. There we go. There we go. It updated. Finally. Something's going horribly wrong.
Arvak! You saved him! His soul is free, I can feel it! He's such a loyal beast. Here, I'll teach you how to call him to you. He'll help you get around this wretched place. But I'm sure he'd be much happier someplace sunnier. Goodbye, hero. Take good care of Arvak for me. Such a good horse.
The caster tries to summon Arvak to his aid? What? Arvak is not a traditional mount in the sense of being able to store things on it. However, it feels like he has Requiem speed, so... Hooray! Requiem touched Dawnguard. That's the one DLC it did touch, which is why there are invisible people everywhere that ruin my goddamn day. I don't know if it is. Yeah. Slower than Requiem speed, are you sure? Yeah, it probably is, actually. Feels pretty fast, though. Probably still faster than going on foot. I know that Requiem touched Dawnguard though, so I'd hope that Arvak's fast. Lasts a while. Can I summon two Arvaks? I can. Let's ride Arvaks. No, Arvak has always been a conjuration spell. I'm pretty sure what you're thinking about is Durnavir, which is most definitely a shout. Oh, I think we found the guys that were angry at us earlier. And an invisible man. Maybe. Oh, I'm aware of the mod Zero, I just kind of want to not touch it if, like, this is the way it's supposed to be. But I am getting really frustrated, so I might give up sometime. Just, like, these entities are really, really stupid, stupid design choice in my opinion, but I want to play Requiem for what Requiem is. What it's supposed to be. Like, that's Requiem Plus or whatever, isn't it? Changes a whole bunch of things that they didn't agree with Requiem. I guess the point of Skyrim is to just mod it and make it the way you want it to be, but it wouldn't make sense to replace all the invisible entities with Soul Torrent entities because they're not all going to appear in the Soul Cairn. Unfortunately. God, the chain yells. My cave on that one because they're really annoying. Not in like a challenging way. They're just, you know, turn around, run away, conjure a few things, and then like hope they don't punch you to death. Done and done. It's not a matter of like using your hand to hand well. It's not a matter of using magic well. It's a matter of like, well, do you have this? No, you're dead. If you don't have a way to detect them, if you don't have a companion that can tank them, you're probably just going to die. Maybe like a warrior. Invisible entities were near invulnerable to magic, so the main way to kill them, that and 600 armor. They don't feel very invulnerable to magic. They take my, like, swarm. I just feel like they have too much health. I don't know if it's their health or their, like, resistances that make them ridiculous. Thing is, sometimes in RPGs there is room for something that's not balanced. I'm just not sure that these things, there's room for these things. Like in D&D, 2k HP and poison isn't magic damage. Oh wow. Alright. Like in D&D, that's what I was saying. I was just trying to say, a basilisk. If it looks at you, it kills you. Like it turns you to stone, you're done. There's room for that though, because like there's things that you can do. You can reverse like petrification with certain spells. You can protect yourself from it with scrolls, potions, and all that other fun stuff. If you know what you're going up against, you can deal with it. If I know what I'm going up against here, I'm going to have to either go and find, like, the shouts. I'm going to have to find those three shouts, which is either going to require me to do, like, the main quest to a point where I can then get random quests to go find shouts, or know where the shouts are and, like, just strategy guide my way through that. Or I'm going to need to be a vampire lord so I can detect life that way. And, like, that just, that doesn't seem like a good design choice to me. It's like, if you can't see them, you can't really see them. And I tried lighting them on fire earlier. I created fire like on the ground. I'm pretty sure I hit them, but they didn't seem to get lit up that way. So I don't know if that was just me missing or what the deal was. I don't know. I forgot to anchor myself again. I clearly just shouldn't be here right now. Unfortunately, I have like the intention of getting through the Dawnguard DLC, which apparently is a no-no, unless you are level 50 plus, or well, I guess this one guy said 30 plus, but yeah, no. I'm almost level 30, which is I'm not 30 plus technically. He's right. I guess I'm supposed to be losing right now. Yeah, I totally get that. I'm not arguing that it's a bad design choice, I'm just... I don't know. Hesitant to fix it because, well, this is Requiem. This is what Requiem is. Action stick, real time, weapons, spells, or sheaths cannot be used. That's kind of cool. Improved potion animation. Animations, Jackson's real names. People will be called strangers until you actually get to talk to them or they talk to you. Alright. You know, so far, really, this is the only problem I've had with Requiem. I mean, I have been really annoyed by the knockback, but really, that's my fault for not wearing heavy armor, and I guess that being their decision. If a bear does, like, jump on you and you're not able to stand up to it, it would probably kill you. It'd be nice if I could flail around on the ground while it's murdering me, at least, instead of just watching as it murders me, but yeah, that's fair, that's fine. Annoying at times, but fair and fine. No more 5 free skill points on every skill you have. What, you start at 0? In a few other places, but these are more visible soul-torn entities. Were literally empty 3D models of the skeleton rigged to them that would make that move successfully than normal and punch you. Do more work than just flipping a switch to make them visible. Edit bad wording. You meant if the only thing I did was to make them visible. Then we have some kind of lame, partially visible, super fast NPC that only used its fists all over Soul Cairn, and it'd still also be headless. It's best quality. I don't know what you're talking about. This is not like potato. I'm not running it on a potato with potato settings. Hit them with a Mage Light spell. So I'm reading is that a sword and board and trying to do a magic RP, I'm pretty much screwed. You just need a very high armor, lots of HP, lots of strong HP potions, and well-smithed weapons. If that fails, add poisons. As long as you don't fight more than one at a time, they aren't so bad once you reach very high levels as a warrior. Penetrate armor by 50%, so go crazy there. Oh, cool. No shame in using the tools you have available. Myself against a bookshelf and the wall to keep him from swarming and attacking molecules. I guess, yeah, that's one way to do it. So I guess I should expect these in every Daedric quest and just randomly around in the world. People say the Blue Palace, they mean like the Pelagius Wing, I'm guessing. Dick Butt Kiss. Am I entirely clear with this one? I'm already clear with this one then. Armor buffer and kiting. I guess I'll just have to go full armor because that's one of the few options for surviving them. Or just getting every shout and going ethereal is an option, I guess. Go talk to St. Jude. see. He's somewhere around here. Isn't he? I thought he was somewhere around here. There's a campfire or something, isn't there? Oh, Serana's found some friends.
Who's there?
I swear he was more in this direction than he was in the other direction. Wait, have I cleared this one? This one doesn't look familiar. I swear I must have though. No, actually, maybe I have. I can't tell. So, you know, I've definitely been here before. You can turn around the Soul Cairn pretty easily. That's the Reaper's Tower, or the Keeper's Tower, and then that's the Reaper's Building, I think? This is the fun fountain of just everyone chase the Wisp. Oh, this isn't the Reaper's place, is it? This is just where you find. Yeah, that is the Reaper's place. Be thankful though, I guess, at least that invisible entities don't regenerate their health other than when they get to a certain health threshold. Where the hell is a good Saint Jude? Ah, there's Arvak's place, so it should be somewhere around here. Speaking of Arvak. Actually running by St. Jube when I was fighting things around here, but maybe I'm remembering wrong, or we wandered far too far from here. How's my heavy armor doing compared to my conjuration, which is already at 70? No, oh, that's very poorly. Imperial courier ran into Dawnstar. Well, that didn't. That can't have ended well, Zero. I should go deal with the last keeper and then continue my search for St. Jupe. Even though I quickly passed him, where the hell was he? I should do one thing, but I'm gonna not do that. Instead, I'm gonna go look for St. Jupe some more. He's somewhere around here, I know he is. Where is the question? There he is. Okay, so between that tower, that building, and that lightning attractor.
Was it having the adoration of thousands? No, wait. I could make it the adoration of tens of thousands. What do you want? How does anyone expect me to write my opus with all of these rude interruptions? What do I mean, indeed? If I hadn't lost all of the pages, I wouldn't be in this predicament, and we wouldn't be having this conversation. Very well. I suppose a moment or two of my time couldn't hurt. I am Jib. Some call me Saint Jib. Others call me Jib the Eradicator. Perhaps you've heard of me.
Jib.
I can't say that I'm surprised by your answer. Until I get my second volume published, no one will ever know of my achievements. A book? I'd hardly call a 26-volume epic simply a book.
Surely you've heard of the rise and fall of St. Jim the Eradicator, hero of Morrowind and savior of the Dunmer. Terrible. Simply terrible. I was in the midst of writing the second volume, and they just threw me into this prison. It's unfair. That damned Remora and his minions. They didn't even give me a chance to explain who I was. Well, I assume so. It cast a spell at me from some kind of strange black crystal. Next thing I knew, I arrived here. My what? Wait. That means...
Yep, no. St. Jim's dead.
All these wasted months? Or has it been years? I don't even remember how much time has passed. No, my work will never see the light of day. My name will be forgotten. Perhaps. Do you have a way out of here? Maybe I can't leave, but my writings can. In order to write the second volume of my opus, I need the notes from my first volume. Otherwise, I need to do all of this from memory. When I was tossed in here, I felt myself falling, and I dropped the pages I've been holding. There were 10 of them in all. Find them for me, please. I beg you.
10?
At this rate.
Okay, I only need 10, 7. No, I have 10 actually. It's way up here at the top. I need 2, 4, and 7.
My first.
Cool.
Don't give up.
Now I'm content to go deal with that. The last keeper. I've forgotten. Is it here where I go up to the keeper and deal with him? No, this just takes me to the top of this tower. Is that the last spell tome? That's the last spell tome. That'll give me my Mistmen. Oh, Arvac, you follow me. How nice. And you're just as immune to fall damage as every other horse in Requiem. Oh, this is gonna be a nightmare. I can only imagine how many things are gonna pop out of the ground to ruin my day. Yes! At least two. It's gonna be misspent. Oh, Jube's Opus. That's one on the pages.
Who's there?
Where's my book? Isn't this where the spell tome is supposed to be? Oh, is that it? Ugh, that's fucked up.
While we can.
Days. There goes all my stamina. Blinding effect of like the ice that they leave for days on the ground. Hey, where'd the Wrathman die, you bastard? Lost a corpse or two. All the goodies. Oh, there's one of them. That's what I'm looking for anyway. I don't know where the Wrathman died, and I'm probably not going to find him, because I wasn't paying attention to the air combat. Serana downed it when I wasn't looking. Anyway, I should have the stamina now to deal with this bastard. Is that the keeper? Just way up to the top, aggroed onto me. Just gonna try and lose aggro. I search for the corpse of what should we call it? Wrathman. Eh, it's gone. Whatever. Our back. Back lasts a really long time now. Don't remember him lasting me this long. Well, so long, cruel world! Oh, I hit the freaking invisible barrier. I'm not dead? How am I not dead? That doesn't make any sense. Is me being a vampire saving my life or something? That should have killed me. Quite painfully. I hope this isn't like an effective enhanced camera. Thanks, Hatronach, thanks. The last keeper. I don't know how vaulting off of this thing did not kill me. Especially when it was like a ragdoll effect, too. I can't take you? Why can't I take you? Like, seriously, how did I survive? Let's see if I can do that again. What is old Steve made out of all of a sudden?
Captain, what happened to my ship? Where am I?
Ebony flesh, eh? Is that it? One miss, man? It's the problem with aggroing the entire frickin' Soul Cairn at once. Once you've killed everything, all the areas where the enemies are supposed to appear are kind of underwhelming. Other than, like, the lightning attractors, which don't aggro. I don't know what I'm thinking, there's no chance I can outrun this thing, even on a horse. Oh, it's tethered onto that thing. She pulled this aggro. Wait, that's not Serana, that's Valerica. Ah, shit. That wasn't Serana helping, that was Valerica. Oh goodness. I guess Valerica hates him as much as I do. Oh wow, okay, I thought the game might have frozen there. Probably keep a bodyguard around at all times, in case like one of those fuckers shows up again. gotten all of Jube's stupid things. I don't know if I have all the Reaper fragments. I don't think I do. Though I'm pretty sure one of them was supposed to spawn over there in a place and I didn't get it. So I don't know. Is that it? Yeah, that's what I remember it being. Nothing much else. Take off the gloves, put on the ring. Now to deal with Durnavir. I'll return to St. Jupe first. St. Jupe. Good old St. Jupe.
Again. These pages meant the world to me. Thank you. Now, volume 2 begins. What else? Oh, wait a moment. Here, I want you to have these before you go. A pristine copy of my first volume. Only one in print, actually. And take this as well. Seeing as St. Jib has ascended to pure spiritual form, I won't need it any longer.
Carrying capacity of 50. Not a bad enchantment in this mod. My normal horse spirit. That'd be awesome. Just lock it on the horse. Have it, equip it. Hey, Valerica, do you mind if I just take your stuff? What stuff do you have here that I want? Take your rolls of paper. Valerica won't talk to me. Where is Serana? Son of a bitch! I forgot to find Serana wherever she is. I feel like she should be over here somewhere. Maybe trapped up top because I teleported up there but jumped down. Hell, Arvak followed me. Where's Serana? There's one solution that will probably work. Damn it, I was hoping changing cells would make her move to me. I may need to cheat my way out of this because I have no idea where I'm at lost here. I don't really want to spend an hour looking for her.
This is all wrong.
Okay, so that's where she is. Now that I know where she is, I'll go there. God, I need to get her like a bell or something to wear. A really obnoxiously loud bell that gives off a beacon of light so I know where she is at all times. Nice, Serana. Follow me. Keep up. Are you trapped up there? Do I need to, like, hit you and send you off a path?
Think a vampire would be.
God damn it, Serana. I don't even have Fusrada. I can't move her from here. She's too fucking derpy. She's not with me. She's still down here.
Damn.
Where'd you come from?
God, it's like the game knows what I'm trying to do and won't let it happen. Serana is must stay here, apparently. It's utterly essential that she stays here. There, stand up. I could solve this problem with the console, I know, but I feel like I really, really shouldn't have to. I can solve a lot of problems. Foos wouldn't be enough to get her off of there, because like it took several. It would be enough if I applied it enough times, but it doesn't knock over, so I couldn't like send her over. No, then fully ragdoll, so it would only. Oh wow, it doesn't even ragdoll her. It doesn't even stagger her. So no, it would not have been enough. Thank goodness she's essential, and I couldn't kill her. I'm just gonna start using the console for everything when I need to. Screw Mother. This game is so fucking Mother. Broke.
It can't be. Serana?
Is it really you? I can't believe it.
Serana, what are you doing here? Where's your father?
He doesn't know we're here. I don't have time to explain.
I must have failed. Harkon's found a way to decipher the prophecy, hasn't he?
No, you've got it all wrong. We're here to complete the prophecy our way, not his.
Wait a moment. You've brought a stranger here? Have you lost your mind?
No, you don't...
You, come forward. I would speak with you.
So how has it come to pass that a vampire of mixed blood is in the company of my daughter?
Safe? You call bringing her here safe? Has she explained nothing to you?
I've been keeping her safe by hitting her with an axe over and over and over and over. Prophecy.
I would have expected her to explain that to you. You think I'd have the audacity to place my own daughter in that tomb for the protection of her Elder Scroll alone? The scrolls are merely a means to an end. The key to the tyranny of the sun is Serana herself. I fled with two Elder Scrolls. The scroll I presume you found with Serana speaks of Auriel and his arcane weapon, Auriel's bow. The second scroll declares that the blood of Cold Harbor's daughter will blind the eye of the dragon. Like myself, Serana was a human once. We were devout followers of Lord Molag Bal. Tradition dictates the females be offered to Molag Bal on his summoning day. Few survive the ordeal. Those that do emerge as a pure-blooded vampire. We call such confluences the Daughters of Cold Harbor. Now you're beginning to see why I wanted to protect Serana. And why I've kept the other Elder Scroll as far from her as possible. If Harkon obtained Auriel's bow, and Serana's blood was used to taint the weapon, the tyranny of the sun would be complete. In his eyes, she'd be dying for the good of all vampires. And how exactly do you plan on completing the prophecy without the death of my daughter? If you believe that, then you're a bigger fool than I originally suspected.
Don't you think I weighed that option before I enacted my plans? You care nothing for Serana, or our plight. You see the tyranny of the sun as your chance at deification. And like Harkon, you won't hesitate to destroy anything that stands in your path. Serana? This stranger may call himself a vampire, but he knows nothing of our struggle. Why should I entrust you to him?
Well, Steve is standing right here. Stranger has done more for me in the time I've known
him than you've done in centuries. How dare you? I gave up everything I cared about to protect you from that fanatic you call a father.
Yes, he's a fanatic. He's changed. But he's still my father. Why can't you understand how that makes me feel?
Serana, if you'd only open your eyes. The moment your father discovers your role in the prophecy, that he needs your blood, you'll be in terrible danger.
So to protect me, you decided to shut me away from everything I cared about. You never asked me if hiding me in that tomb was the best course of action. You just expected me to follow you blindly. Both of you were obsessed with your own paths. Your motivations might have been different, but in the end, I'm still just a pawn to you two. I want us to be a family again. But I don't know if we can ever have that. Maybe we don't deserve that kind of happiness. Maybe it isn't for us. But we have to stop him before he goes too far. And to do that, we need the Elder Scroll.
I'm sorry, Serana. I didn't know. I didn't see. I've allowed my hatred of your father to estrange us for too long. Forgive me. If you want the Elder Scroll, it's yours. Your intentions are still somewhat unclear to me.
You're still somewhat unclear to old Steve, too.
I'll assist you in any way that I can. Yes. I've kept it safely secured here ever since I was imprisoned. Fortunately, you seem to have already killed the keepers maintaining the barrier around these ruins. Yes. Please, follow me. One more word of warning. There's a dragon that calls itself Durnavir roaming the cairn. The Ideal Masters have charged him with overseeing the keepers, and will undoubtedly investigate the fact that the barrier has fallen.
See how badly. Whoa. No, not the giant mud crabs. I remember seeing a video forever ago of like mud crab like. The size of Godzilla or some shit in like a little video. But never seen that as an actual mod. Anyway, I'm gonna get some water real quickly. I'll be right back. Hopefully the terrain was just a temporary bug and not an issue caused by God knows what. Nope, the train in here is just fucked. Great.
I hear something.
I'm gonna restart the entire game, see if that fixes it. This is too annoying. If it fails to correct it, what I will do is I'll just toggle grass, because those are probably all just grass objects.
Come on in.
Yep, it's just some fucked up bullshit. Fuck, fuckity fuck. That's just a messed up mod interaction. Let's slay some dirt up here. He's just staring at me like, yo, what are you gonna do? Punch nothing is what?